Sketchbook versus Photoshop. Let's go, baby. Ain't nothing like a good digital art software comparison video. Am I right or am I right?
First off, guys, that there are quite a few differences to be aware of when comparing Sketchbook versus Photoshop. Boo-hoo. But guess what? We're about to learn you something right here. For those of you that complain about long, drawn-out videos, you can also see an in-depth, full comparison list between Sketchbook and Photoshop by visiting our resource page. Go get it, girl, Fosho.
Girl? Fosho!
Now, to see that resource page, visit Google and type Media Peanut followed by Sketchbook versus Photoshop. Should look a little something like this. However, if you don't want to move your thumbs, then you can enjoy the long, boring, drawn-out video. Totally kidding, by the way.
Oh, and don't you dare like, subscribe, or even comment. Because, well, we won't be answering them. Oh, and a ho-ho-ha-ha-ho to you too.
Between Sketchbook and Photoshop software for digital art, then you're in the right spot. In this video, we're going to cover which drawing software is the best, what features are unique, and which is best depending on your goals as an artist.
For beginner-friendly work, Sketchbook is the better choice. However, for those looking for more advanced, all-rounder, for everything from graphics to editing photos, Photoshop is the clear winner. Sketchbook's learning curve is less steep than that of Adobe Photoshop.
By the end of this, artists will know whether Photoshop or Sketchbook is the best software for their needs. For starters, Sketchbook is free to download and use. That automatically makes it a better choice than Photoshop for those on a budget. It has numerous advanced drawing tools, lots of brushes, and comprehensive panels, selection tools, and toolbars. On the flip side, why is Photoshop the most popular software for creative professionals? Well, there are good reasons. As an amazing all-rounder, there's nothing Photoshop cannot do.
Comparing Sketchbook vs. Photoshop is not easy. After all, both applications are amazing tools for creatives. However, each software does a better job than the other at certain tasks. For many years, Adobe Photoshop has been the most popular editing software on the market.
In fact, over 90% of creative professionals around the world use Photoshop. It is obvious that this battle will be an uphill one for Sketchbook. But as a reliable software that has been around for more than 10 years, Sketchbook is also hard to beat.
The post we won't stop talking about in the description explains more in depth things nobody is mentioning about these two drawing softwares. It also covers one secret nobody is talking about.
Now you have two options here. One, you can sit through the next 8 minutes of video like Jabba the Hutt. Or two, in 0.5 seconds you can instantly see more advanced information which is laid out clearly on our website. Go to Google. Type Media Peanut, then Sketchbook versus Photoshop. Look for the Media Peanut website. You'll be able to instantly see the solution and view all the hard-to-find information you need.
This video will still be available on that page if you need it. Now, when I say the page has everything you need, it really does have everything you need. Go get it, girl, Fosho.
Girl? Fosho.
If not, our tech expert Roberto Estaban Rojas Fernandez, the third, is going to explain the rest.
When it comes to manipulating raster and vector graphics and photos, it simply doesn't get any better than Photoshop. With this app, a designer, artist, or photographer can even create animations, 3D images, etc.
It is powerful when it comes to drawing and is free to use. On the other hand, Photoshop is simply the most powerful editing application on the market. To find out which software is best for you, let us explore the key differences between the two programs.
Although both Sketchbook and Photoshop can be used on pretty much any operating system, Windows, macOS, Android, iPadOS, and iOS, their system requirements differ significantly.
To be more specific, Photoshop is a more demanding software than Sketchbook. You might be able to run Photoshop with a basic hardware set of PG 2 GB RAM, Sketchbook or processor, but you'll need a pretty powerful system to have a smooth editing experience.
Even professionals who have been using Photoshop for years do not use all of its features. That's how advanced it is. With ultimate control over shapes, colors, animations, drawings, photo editing tools, and more, there's nothing better than Photoshop.
So while Sketchbook offers many editing features and tools, Photoshop is simply unbeatable in this area, where you can perform extremely interesting tasks like changing someone's hair color in comparison to the original photo or stretching limbs to unrealistic measures. Even though both Sketchbook and Photoshop has ideal advanced functions needed in terms of color, texture, grayscales, layering, I found Photoshop to be more intuitive simply because I'm used to the Adobe suite. Both allow for the typical formats, including, but not limited to PSD, as well as 3D formats like UD303, KML, OBJ, and more. Summary. Overall, when choosing between Sketchbook and Photoshop, you'll want to consider whether you need complex digital artwork done or if you need something simple.
Hit the like button if you like my pointless orange javest.
Hit the like button if you like my pointless orange vest better.
In conclusion, use Sketchbook for simple sketching tasks and Photoshop for everything else related to digital painting and retouching.
Don't forget, more in-depth information on this is also available. In 0.5 seconds, you can instantly see more advanced information, which is laid out clearly on our website. Go to Google, type Media Peanut, then Sketchbook versus Photoshop. Look for the Media Peanut website. You'll be able to instantly see the solution and view all the hard-to-find information you need.
Please subscribe to the channel, my friends. It will help you every day.